Warning! Some users may find the following video disturbing. So if you f***ing don't like it, deal with it. So give this video a f***ing like. So here we are in the game of Deadliest Catch, Alaskan Storm. I decided to pick up this game because I got pissed off at the other one. So many fucking problems. It was boring. And then someone in my Discord recommended this to me, and then I saw it, picked it up, bought it, and here we go. I played a little bit of it, but I'm gonna make a new player. I already made a new one. So we're gonna start off with a new game here. And, let's start with a new game.
Mayday, mayday. This is the FB Arctic Lights. We are taking on water and require immediate assistance. There are 4 people on board. Mayday.
Here we are, I guess.
We're right outside Dutch Harbor, and we've just got a nasty weather report with some storm force winds heading our way. The safest thing to do is to turn around and head back into port.
No shit.
The autopilot is set. All you need to do is run the throttle and control the speed. Why don't you take the wheel and see what you got?
Okay, we could do this. The northern weather. The northern western is too far away to be of any assistance to the Coast Guard. Well, okay, that's good to know. We should go into port. The only thing you could do right now is head to Dutch Harbor, okay? And wait for the storm to pass. All right.
Left click and drag the throttle handle all the way up to get the boat to full speed. Or press the up arrow key on your keyboard.
Up, okay, I'll just do that. Release. Ooh, can I fix that camera control? Yeah. That inverted player. Okay, so what? Oh, they want me to. Okay. Is there,
You can look around the boat by holding down the right mouse button while moving the mouse.
Yeah, I figured that one out.
You can.
One of us is.
Let me just fix that real quick. There you go, and I can see my mouse.
Keep the throttle up and head for the harbor. You need to get into the bay before the storm hits.
I know that. Oh, wow, that bounce. These are some waves. Now this is what the other game should have been like.
Battle scars now.
Oh, great. That's good to know. Full throttle. That's a big wave. Big wave. Really big one. Oh, shit. Boat was about to be submerged. RRG. Or, no, GR.
Good job.
You
made it back safe.
Sorry.
Just in time, too. Those swells are getting bigger by the minute.
Yeah, no shit.
There's nothing else to do, but hope.
Okay, yeah, we get that. Sea slack fishing. Nah, we want to keep that motion. Oh, we can now access the mission list. Oh. Okay. Look around your boat cabin with the camera. Okay.
Well, it looks like the weather came down real nice today. And we need to get over to the other side at the dock and pick up Matt. He's been shopping for groceries and all our supplies. Why don't you take the boat and run her over there? I'll sit back and watch. Just don't crash my boat.
Okay.
You can bring up a list of all the game controls at any time.
F1. Oh my god. is a lot of buttons. Center, rudder, camera, zoom, cabin light, prop. We have a radio, okay. Switch chairs, tab, or caps lock. Shift, close, okay. Seems
you can look
simple.
Around the cabin by holding the Ooh. Right mouse button down while moving the mouse.
Can we walk around in this one?
There's a group of sea lions on the shore to your right. Turn the camera to look at them now.
Where? Oh. Hello.
Good. You can center the view again at any time. Matt is waiting for you at the dock. You'll have to navigate through the entrance of the bay to go pick him up.
Okay. Pretty simple.
The radar shows you points of interest around your boat.
Okay.
Your boat is always pointing up on the...
No shit.
The plus and minus buttons on the right of the radar display and the plus and minus keys on the numeric...
All right. We got
Left
this.
Left click and drag the throttle handle all the way up to make the boat move forward.
Then we do that. We go forward.
Keep the throttle up to reach the entrance of the bay. Don't forget to
we'll
use the camera
throttle.
Controls or the reset view button to see where you're going.
Pretty simple.
You know, that's the Coast Guard Mellon out there. He's a 400-foot cutter. Right now, we're on a collision course with him. You do need to stop and let him pass. These are the rules of the road you got to follow.
I thought it was
bring the throttle back to its center position to stop the engines. You can also...
What? I thought it's... Everyone goes right. I do have my boating license, and I do know that. You always turn right to the oncoming person in front of you. You never turn left. That's the lane. Oh, I guess it's because that's shoreline, and... I don't know. You win this time, Coast Guard. But we're pushing on through. I don't care. There you go. Push on through, going whatever... amount of knots that is. And we just lost all that momentum.
You can move the rudder lever left and right or use the left and right arrow. The rudder angle display shows the current angle of your boat's rudder. Push the rudder to the right for a few seconds until your rudder shows an angle of about 20 degrees.
What's 20 degrees? Okay. That's 20 degrees, I guess.
Hey, that looks like the shellfish. It seems he's going into the bay as well.
Shellfish.
And by that puff of smoke I just saw coming out of the boat, he wants to race us in there.
Okay.
What? You guys want to race?
Well, yeah, screw it.
Go full throttle to beat the shellfish to the entrance of the bay.
Yeah, we'll win this. Your boat ain't faster than mine. We need to get up to... How fast can this boat go? Can I realign that? I don't want to go into the...
Now would be a clicking on the... Click on the rudder angle display, or press the N key. Steer your boat into the bay before the shellfish.
Yeah, no shit. We're gonna win this. We need to get up to 12 knots. Come on. Everything she got. See that? That's what you call speed. Yeah, we're gonna win this. No problem. No problem. Absolutely no problem in beating that person. Or the sea hook? Or sea fish. Or shellfish. It's the list right there.
Well done. You beat the shellfish.
Yeah, I beat him.
Way to go. Looks like we beat them in there.
Yeah.
Shellfish is always bragging about how fast they are. It turns out Northwestern has all the speed you need.
Sorry if I was picking up that tapping noise for the past, like, long time.
You can use the mouse wheel or click on the... Good. When zoomed out, you can use the controls at the bottom.
Okay.
You can look around your boat. A bow thruster is
push
the bow thruster stick to the left.
Okay, we get
it. Or press the delete key on your keyboard to rotate your boat towards the dock.
Goodness me. I understand this is a tutorial, but really came a long way. Come on.
Good. You can go ahead and dock the boat now. Use the throttle and rudder to make your way to the dock and come to a full stop inside the glowing box.
But I don't want to use the rudder. I want to use the blower. I'm going to have to use the rudder. And there. About good enough. Go about that speed. Good. Just
slow down as you get close. You need to come to a full stop inside the box to dock the boat.
Okay, I will go into the box and then slowly stop. Now, slam it into reverse.
You guys sure took your sweet time.
And I did it. Yay, whatever that was, I think it meant I unlocked something. It was that unlock noise. Oh. Today, you will learn to use propeller. Okay.
You know, I think we've been screwing around the harbor long enough. Why don't we get out to sea and go set some strings and start fishing? Let's see how you do.
Okay.
Head past the harbor buoy into the open sea.
We'll see how I do fishing. I could do fishing pretty well. But I guess we're gonna go past this buoy. Okay.
The plotter is where you plan your fish.
The plotter is one of the greatest tools on a crab boat. It can give you an overall picture of where your pots are laid out and all your strings. It'll tell you where you're at compared to all of your gear and how far these pots are spaced out. Plus, it gives you different depths on the bottom as well. Plotter is really important to a crab fisherman.
Well, that's
you can zoom in and out on the map by using the...
Yeah, figured that one out.
You can look around the map by holding down the right mouse button, and you can also use the controls on the side of the screen to navigate around the map. The display tabs control...
Okay.
Every summer, the Alaska Department of Fish and Game conducts a survey on how many crab are actually out there for us to fish. It's a good idea to look at the survey to get an idea where to start. Just remember, the crab do tend to move around.
Now that we have an idea of where the crabs are located, a line of pots is called a string. Click the left mouse button anywhere on the map to start creating a string in the plotter.
Where should we go?
Good.
Say
now
here.
Move the mouse to where you would like your string. Good. Now that you know how to create strings, let's go and place one where... Now that you know where you'll be dropping your gear, you need to get in position using the left mouse button. Click and drag your boat icon all the way to the location. Now that a waypoint has been set... Good. You now click on the exit button.
Okay.
At any given time, the crew is currently...
Alrighty, let's see what they do. Oh, here they go.
As soon as the crew is in set pots mode, they... Navigate your boat close to the... Get close to the first drop position and wait for the crew to be ready to drop the pot.
Okay. Your first pot set. Our first pot set will be so amazing. It's gonna be so amazing when we put the pot in the water. Because we get crab. Crabs love pot. Alright, here we go. Are you excited, guys? This is our first pot of the day. Be excited. You're not showing any energy.
The crew is ready to drop the pot.
Yeah, space.
Click on the buzzer or press the space bar to give them...
Ta-da! Our first pot.
Congratulations. You've just set your first pot.
I did.
Right on the spot.
And it was right on
now
the spot.
Now go to the next drop location to set the second
I
pot.
I see what you did there.
The drop positions appear in white on your radar. The pot... Drop the next pot at the second location.
Oh, shit. We just...
Remember to ring the buzzer to instruct the crew to drop the pot when they're ready.
Come on. Get the pot up, guys.
This is the USCG Mellon. We have located the life...
Who cares about the life, right? got some pots to set out. Set these pots.
This is the USCG Mellon. All four crew members are inside the life.
Good for you.
Thank God. One more crew.
Well, it sounds like everything went okay with that.
Okay. I want to fish. I don't want to hear any more tutorial stuff. I want to fish. Come on, guys. You gotta get this going. Alright, set the pot. Let's go.
You can click on the deck cam. Oh.
Ooh,
the deck cam
deck
gives
cam.
You a... Good.
What,
go set the last pot to complete your string.
Alright, so we can even tell by just looking at that screen. That's cool. Alright, last one. Let's do it. Ooh, there's stuff up here. Go straight. Come on. You're set.
Great.
There we go.
You have completed your first string.
Yay.
The red bar next to each fish. The longer your crew members work without, put the crew back.
Okay, go to sleep.
Now that your string is set, you need to let it soak for a while.
Okay.
Open the plotter again to access the fast time mode.
I guess we should just do that and go like this.
If no waypoint is set for your boat, activating the fast time mode will simply make time. We'll give this string a... The clock shows the current date and time. Stay in fast time until the pots have soaked long enough.
What's good enough?
U.S. Coast Guard Cody.
How long is good enough?
You know, there's a boat nearby our...
The search icon on the plotter indicates the rough area of the missing boat. Set a waypoint at the location of the... Activate fast time again to travel to the... Good. You're now in position to start searching for the missing boat. Exit the plotter.
We're looking for a missing...
It's a bit dark in the cabin at this... Now keep an eye out for that boat in distress.
Even though the light
remember
makes
that
it
it's
harder
easier
for me
to
see.
Spot things around you if you zoom the camera out.
Zoom the camera out. Okay. Oh.
Captain, someone just fired a flare.
Locate the missing boat by following the flare signals.
Following the flare signals. There's only one boat that should be firing flares, and that's the one in distress. But off we go. We're coming. And straighten up. There we go. Straighten up. All right, off we go into the journey to save this lost boat, even though you have a GPS, which I guess is not working. So that's maybe why they're in distress. We got no crabs, birds, so why are you, like, circling? Who cares? We're coming, you don't... how many flares does this boat have? Wasn't that, like, the fourth one now?
If it's
the
ship is not
one.
Responding on the radio. Get close enough to it to be able to communicate
so
with the crew.
Is that acknowledging they have no power? Okay, we see the flare. Is there a horn button? There's a horn button. Nope. No horn button. Or is there? I could press F. Horn button, where are you? Do we really not have a horn button? No horn button. Okie dokie, here we come. We're coming to save you. We're coming. Here we come. The Northern Western is here to
save
you.
Hey there. It's really nice to see you guys. We've had a massive power surge.
Oh, maybe that's why.
Well, if I knew it was those guys out here, I'd have let them drift around just a little bit longer. But I think we need to get a hold of Coast Guard and see if we can't help them out.
Click on the radio panel. The radio menu. Click on the Coast Guard button.
Roger that, Northwestern.
Click on the exit button. It looks like this fish...
Okay, yay. Is that it? Oh, now we learned this. Okay.
You know, we're still in town after helping Captain Larry out yesterday.
We just magically
teleported
there.
You can edit the payload.
Yep.
Use the up and down arrows to change the number of pots on your boat.
Let's say 20.
Set the total number of pots on your boat. Increase the amount of fuel on board until you have at least...
Stability is a big part of crab fishing. It's all about the center of gravity on your boat.
Oh, so we have gravity simulation on this? Oh, that's great.
Click on the reset button to bring your...
Oh. Yeah, I just wanted to say thanks for the tow line.
Don't care.
Fill the boat all the way up with bait, and you'll be ready to head out.
Okay.
The wait time field displays the amount... Click on the perch...
Captain, you've got to help me. I've got a girl in my bunk, and my girlfriend just showed up.
All right.
Click on the purchase button again to resume loading the boat. Good. The boat. Now you need to plot a course to your gear.
Plot.
Set a waypoint near the start of your string.
Let's go get the string.
Activate
that's been
fast
sitting
time
there
to
for
start
two
traveling.
Days.
You are now in position to start retrieving gear.
Before
leaving
the
plotter,
so it's been there
set
for
another waypoint
hours.
At the other end of your string.
Okay.
This will allow you. Good. Close the. Set the crew mode to click the autopilot. The autopilot does navigate to the first pot location. Remember that you have to approach the buoys on the starboard, right side of the boat for your crew to retrieve the pots.
Okay. Simple. Very simple. Everyone get out. You gotta get some pots. You gotta get some crab. From three pots.
Steering the boat
out for a day or 3 days almost. Unless this is teaching me something.
Make sure to slow to retrieve the first pot. Remember to approach the pot from the right side.
Yeah, we're already on the right side. Come on. There we go. Some expert throwers. Look at that. Come on, let's see. And we got crab. How much? I don't know. I need to sort that. Come on, guys, pick it up. Gotta pick it up.
Great job. That pot is stuffed. She's
no,
up.
No, it's not. It's only half stuffed. We haven't even finished this string yet, so don't congratulate me yet. Fill that
every
table.
Every time you retrieve a pot, the crew will give you a count of the number of adult male crabs in it, or keepers. Click the set back button to rebait the pot and drop it back in the same location.
Close enough.
Good job.
Hey, Nick, something's...
Stop playing with...
You can click on the picture of a crew. Click on the numbered button.
Sure.
Good. Move on to the next pot. Remember to slow down when you get close to the pot. If you come too fast on the buoys, your crew could miss the throw, and you'd be forced to circle around to try again.
We only got 1% crab from that. That's not a lot.
That's the second pot. Only one left to complete the string.
That's not a lot of crab, only 1%. Isn't a lot of crab. Come on, guys, move quicker.
If the crab count in your pot was low, you would want to choose the stack option instead of setting back. Stacking means placing the pot back on deck so you can drop it in a better location at a future time. Now, go get the last pot.
Was that an option and I just did not see it? All right. Wow, we didn't even get a percent. We only got 0.8. And toss that hook. And perfecto. Guess we
great.
Start rotating.
You've retrieved the last pot.
Yep. And what does it have? Let's see. Somewhat good. I can't really tell now based on the counts. They just said. Nope. Now what? Yeah, it only doesn't let me stack. Wants me to set back. Close enough. What's that wind noise?
Now that you have retrieved the entire string, you need to go back to harbor to sell your catch.
Open map.
While we are in the plotter, let's take a look at the info. Click on the crab check. The crab tab gives you an in. You can hover over a crab. All right. Hover the mouse cursor over any harbor icon to bring up information about that harbor.
Okay.
The top line of the harbor information menu shows how many boats are. As you can see, there's a set a waypoint on Akutan, then activate fast time to go there.
Okay.
Good. We are done in the plotter. Click the exit button. Make your way to your docking location.
Oh, I guess we gotta dock it. Dock the boat. Dock the boat. Dock the boat. Just need to dock the boat. Just need to dock the boat. Docking the boat. And then the next episode we can actually play. Because this tutorial was so fucking long. I didn't know that. And if I did, I wouldn't have recorded all this. But I haven't seen videos really capturing the whole tutorial beginning here. And sorry, I skipped some of the bits. But yeah, it gets really... with its amount of things it wants to tell us. But can we at least go 12 knots? Come on. Could have gotten us closer at least. There we go, finally. Almost there. Come on. Come on, pass in the yellow line now.
Come to a stop inside the dock area to go to harbor mode.
I know that. Now, beeline into reverse.
Click on the dock. Click on the sell catch tab. You can see your current play. Click on the wait button.
Sell
your catch.
Nice
job. That was crap money.
Way to go. You brought the boat back in one piece with no damages.
Okay, good.
Congratulations. You have sold your first batch of crab.
Yay. Now what? Oh my god, there's another tutorial? No? Thank you. Finally, can we play? New career. Oh wow, we can finally play. But you know what? You're gonna have to wait till the next episode to see that. Hope you're gonna enjoy this let's play, because the last Deadliest Catch, oh my god, that sucked, but this one has way more to offer. So, yeah, you know what to do.